In this video, we're going to install Ruby on Rails 7 and create our first Ruby on Rails 7 app. In the previous video, I installed Ruby version 3. Now, if you want, you can use Ruby 2.7 or upwards. So anything above 2.7 should be fine to use Ruby on Rails version 7. So before we get too deep into this, the first thing I'm going to do is just using the Ruby on Rails guides. I'm going to go through and make sure that we have all of the different requirements installed already. So for example, I'm using Ruby Version Manager for containing all of the libraries or all of the gems within that one gem set. So I have multiple versions of Ruby running on my computer, but this just makes it easy to control where everything is set up. So in order to do this, first of all, in the terminal, I'm going to run Ruby Version Manager. So RVM list, and you'll see here that we have got the latest, we have version 3.0.0 of Ruby. Now that's the latest one according to Ruby Version Manager. There are newer versions of Ruby, but we're going to go with this one anyway. So we can see that this is the current one. I've got this loaded at the moment. The next thing on the list is to check what version of Ruby we're using. So of course, we've loaded this one via RVM, but I can also just say Ruby and get the version like this. You can see we've got 3.0.0. The next thing on the list here is the database. So this is SQLite 3. I think I've got SQLite 3 already installed. SQLite. Oh, okay, he doesn't understand that. SQLite version. Okay, typos here already. Okay, SQLite 3 version, and you see I've got 3.24.0. Now I don't really use SQLite 3, but I would normally use Postgres, but you can do the same for Postgres. I can say Postgres version. So we've got 9.6.5 for Postgres. So we've got the database already set up. Already installed, sorry, don't have the database set up yet. We've got the database installed. So we have Ruby installed, we've got our database installation. And another requirement here is Node. So let's check this out, Node version, 15.14. So it says here that it should be greater than 8.16. So that should be okay. Yarn. Now I'm pretty sure I've got Yarn installed already from working with Rails 6. So 1.22.17. So that should be okay. Clear the screen. So now the next thing to do is install Ruby on Rails. So I've set up a new gem set. I'm using a new gem set within Ruby version 3. So I've got no gems installed at the moment. So I'm going to go ahead and run gem install Rails. So this will pull down all of the required gems that Rails is dependent on. So anything that Rails requires will get installed once we do this. So 35 gems have been installed. So now we can say Rails version, and we've got 7.0.1. So we've got Rails 7 installed now. So now let's go ahead and create our first Rails application using Rails 7. So we'll say Rails new, let's call this Rails 7 blog. I'm not going to pass any parameters in here to customize the install or anything at this point. So you can pass in a particular database type, for example, if we want to use Postgres, or we could disable the testing and the testing directories that get installed and a number of other things. But I've just gone with the very basic install here, so the very basic new application setup. So I haven't done anything customized for this new Rails app. I've just gone with the default settings. So that should include SQLite 3. It should include a number of testing files and a number of other things that by default we might not need in terms of building something really simple, but this is just all of the default stuff that gets set up when you create a new Rails app. So let's have a look here. Next thing to do then is just to go into our folder. So I'm gonna cd into this Rails 7 blog, clear the screen. Let's have a look at what files there are. So we got a gemlog file as normal. Gemlog file. Most of this looks the same as the previous versions of Ruby, just from a quick overview glance, but I'm sure there's gonna be a lot of new things in here. So we've got the app directory, which is the same as the previous versions of Ruby. Almost the same anyway. We've got models, views, helpers, mailers, channels, jobs, assets. We have the config folder, which contains like database settings, routes, all of that stuff. And then the database folder is like for your schema file, database migrations. What else we got here? We've got the lib file, lib directory, for modules, custom modules and things like that. Public directory for all our static files. Storage, this is for active storage. So once you upload photos or documents, it gets stored within this storage directory. And then we have our unit tests, fixtures, all of that stuff within the test directory. Vendor, gitignore. Yeah, so most of this stuff is very similar in terms of Ruby 5, or Ruby on Rails 5, Ruby on Rails 6. Most of this stuff appears to be the same at this point. I'm sure once we dive into this much deeper, there will be a lot of things that are different, but I think from the outset, things look very similar to how it was previously. So if we run Rails Server now, we should be able to see this working in our, let me just clear the screen first. So if you run Rails Server, we should be able to just see this working in our browser. So it's running Puma. And we can see that this is running on port 3000, the same as it was previously. So, and we can see that we've got the web page here. This is like the default page once you install Ruby on Rails 7. You've got like, let me just move my, so we've got Rails 7, we've got Ruby version 3. So that's the basic install of a new Ruby on Rails 7 application. Of course, we could have passed in some parameters that allows us to set a different database type or choose, for example, Bootstrap or a different CSS framework once you launch. But this just gets us up and running with the most basic version of Ruby on Rails 7. This is a very short and simple video just to set up Ruby on Rails 7, but if you want to dive in much deeper, we're going to do videos on building applications using Ruby on Rails 7, so make sure to check those out when they get released. So make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you get updates when I do those videos. So at this point, if you have encountered any problems in the earlier parts of this video, like if you don't have any of these things installed, make sure to check out the guide, the Ruby on Rails guides, and they will give you links to install Node.js or install Yarn. So any of those things that you are missing, you can just follow the guide and install the requirements. So all in all, very easy to set this up if you have been working on Ruby on Rails before. If this is your first time using a Ruby on Rails, then you may encounter some issues, but most of the information you need will be found within the Ruby on Rails guide, so make sure to check that out. I am planning on working on a new Ruby on Rails course, so more information will come out on that very soon. If you are new to Ruby on Rails, make sure to check out the courses I have available on my website. I have two courses there, one for learning Ruby and one for learning Ruby on Rails 6. Now I will plan to come out with a new Ruby on Rails 7 version of the course in the near future, but check that one out in the meantime if you want to get up and running quickly. That's about it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one.